everyone. Welcome back. This is part two of the 1997, I believe, AT-ST driver, and we're starting it off with a full shot of this AT-AT from 1983, which I'll be reviewing in a future video because we're doing a light restoration on it. And since it's from the Jedi boxed version, I have all my troops ready for Endor to take on the Rebel Alliance and the Ewoks. We've got some vintage figures in here and some modern figures, as you see. I took them out so it didn't fall on camera, because it takes a little bit to kind of put back in its hand. But we have the drivers here for the AT-ST down below. And we're looking at 1984 and 1997. So, obviously these are both great figures. I had this as a kid. This was a very fun figure. I didn't get a AT-ST Walker till later on. And I didn't even really play with it. I just had him sitting there. But, and as you can see in a future video, we have a Scout Walker. So we will be reviewing that as well. Yeah, really cool figures, and we're going to take a look at them. So, right here, we have the vintage one. Very simple, very basic articulation. It's just a gray, you know, jumpsuit and, you know, black paint everywhere on his belt, you know, for his Imperial emblem, which is very screen accurate for 1984, and he's got the classic helmet on and the goggles and this gun, which is kind of a pain to put in his hand because it likes to fall out. And these usually get lost. So if you're looking to get one, make sure it's not a repro one. Unless you want that, I would go with original because it adds more value to this figure. But yeah. And then we have is the 97 version. And mine has a little bit of a factory default on its nose, which doesn't really bother me. Probably just shows you how fast Kenner was pumping these out in the mid-90s. And as you could also see, its outfit is a little bit more of a cream color, probably more screen accurate. Its emblem has some more detail. It has some silver paint inside there. Its boots and gloves are the same color as the vintage counterpart, except they made the belt buckle more screen accurate, which is a silver, and they added more lifelike flesh tones as well. And the helmet is a little bit more screen accurate as well, and we got the silver detail on the back as well, and we got some also black detail around the trim, so more screen accurate. Does have the 5 points of articulation. They both do. You know, that was very popular back then. And yeah, they're both very fun figures to play with. Obviously, you get this big heavy blaster, I believe they say, comes with this figure, and a Stormtrooper's blaster. Here, you just get a little laser pistol, hand pistol. So, yeah. I like them both. They're both great figures. You know, obviously, being a collector now for the last 15 years, I'm going to go with the vintage one. But this one will always have a special place in my heart. You know, and, you know, they're both great figures. You know, I'd say 10 out of 10 for both of them, but this one to me has the more of the nostalgic factor. But yeah, they have come out with later AT-ST drivers. I wasn't really crazy about them. I got one in 2012 and I sold it a year or two later. They made the torso swivel. The Stormtroop blaster was very flexible. And you know, a lot of them were warped because it's plastic and, you know, it's cheap plastic. And yeah, I wasn't really too crazy about them. But these I like the best because they're simple and they're straight to the point. And in terms of price, this is $20 to $40 right here. maybe it's gone up a little more. It's this little blaster that adds the value. A lot of these were lost, and there's a lot of reproductions out there. This is original here. I would try to get it with that. And then on the right here, this is not even a joke. You could pay the same price for a 90s AT-ST driver as you did in 1997, which is like $5 to $7. So not really that bad. And like I said, they're both worth having in your collection here. I'm kind of glad that they have the home for the AT-AT Walker and Scout Walker as well, and also for dioramas as well. So it's really great. So all I have to say is stay tuned for future videos. And on top of that, I will be replying to comments on some of the videos I have released recently. So we have a lot coming, especially during these COVID times. So I finally have time to catch up with everything. So anyways, see you in a future video.